Thank you, Mike. Hello, everybody. Good morning. Thanks for coming to this early first talk of this dev room. It's the second year of the backup and recovery dev room here in the FOSDEM. So very pleased to be here again for a second time. Today, I'm going to talk about past, the present, and the future of the DRLM project. So just let's start. My name is Didac Oliveira. I'm the co-owner and co-founder at Brain Updaters. Brain Updaters is a small company, consultancy company, that is based on providing solutions on top of open source projects. So I'm also a co-founder and the maintainer of the DRLM project. We're going to talk in this talk. And I've contributed a few with Relax and Recover. Gracian is going to talk and Johannes after me. And a few ports to config to HTML project. So these are the original DRLM team. We have new people in the project now, Nefix, and a few contributions from Joan and in the room also today. So let's start with the agenda of the talk. We're going to talk a little bit about the past, what's the origin of the project. Very fast, so don't worry about that. It's too early today. Then what's the present of the project? What is the DRLM and what is coming and what is in the last release version? And what about the future of the project? So let's start with the past. Well, the past starts with a requirement of one of our biggest customers that need a proper solution for Linux systems and their disaster recovery. So it's a pharma industry and needs a lot of stuff and validations for disaster recovery of their systems. They proved and test a lot of tools for disaster recovery. And every try failed. So asked us, and we proposed to use Relax and Recover and develop a management layer on top of that for them, because they needed some some management solution for on top of that for the data centers. So this started at summer of 2013, and at the end of the year we had the first ready to use version of the DRLM for them, and that was the very beginning. So to see what's today the real use of the project for them, I'm not going to talk because we don't have time today for that. But you can check these slides that what the Grifols global manager for Unix systems said about the project and what is the project for them at the company. So let's pass just a small timetable about what's the from the beginning to today, the latest version. So let's start talking about the present of the project. First of all, I hopefully agree that everybody knows more or less what is the Relax and Recover. So we're going to talk later about that. And DRLM is just a layer on top of that for management, yeah? Central management. So let's talk about a little bit about some of the features that DRLM adds on top of Relax and Recover, that it's automatic error reporting. So, sorry. If any backup fails, it's going to be able to open a ticket or report an alert for your monitoring systems and can be extended with any monitoring system. It's going to be able to perform an unattended installation of Relax and Recover and all its dependencies and all the base configuration stuff from the DRLM server. So you are going to just say add client, install client, and it's going to do all the boring stuff for you. And also it's going to, it has a backup schedule. You can schedule some tasks on that, and it's going to perform the backups weekly, monthly, daily, hourly, whatever you want. So, and there is another important feature that is going to be able, you are going to be able to export and import the disaster recovery images. So you are going to be able to export and import from the same server, but you can export an image from one DRLM server in the data center A and import in the data center B on whatever it is, and you can recover that system on them. So what's DRLM? Mainly, DRLM is a disaster recovery solution. So you are going to be able to recover a system fully from network. So whatever is a virtual machine, hardware, you are going to be able to recover the system. So its mainly task is disaster recovery. But the years passed, and we used a lot. We are not just the developers. We are also users of the project. So we found that it's a very interesting tool for deploying new systems. So we are able to deploy new systems with a base image of a previously installed system, what is called a template or a golden image. We can have different images of our base configs, base systems, and we can import adding a new client and deploy that operating system. So it's a good way to use for that. And also is a very interesting tool for performing migrations. Why? Because it's a vendor agnostic solution. So you can migrate from different virtual systems, virtualization systems, from VMware to Chen, to KVM, whatever, because it's vendor agnostic. You don't need to use tools linked to the vendor. There are tools to do that, but mostly can fail depending on where you're coming and the destination of the system. So this is a good tool to do that. We are going to be able to swap all hardware to the new hardware very fast also. And also, if you want to roll back from a virtualization that it's not working properly and you need to go back to physical, it's easy to do that with DRLM. You just need to boot from network again on the system and recover that. It's very fast. So, and you can say, well, there are other tools to do these migrations. There are other tools still for doing operating system deployments. Good tools, yeah. Why to use DRLM for that? Well, anybody in the room does testing of their backup systems, test it every year, every 6 months, do you test it? The recovery? More or less, I'm not your boss, so you you don't need to lie to me. Well, with DRLM, when you are migrating your new systems, while you are installing new systems on your company, you are going to test your disaster recovery solution. So while you are using daily for this kind of tasks, we are going to be sure that hopefully never happens, but in case of disaster, you're going to be sure that your disaster recovery solution works because you use it daily with your systems, your new hardware that it's going to be installed. The first time, you are going to have a few problems, maybe. But you are going to solve them at installation time. That it's, there is no worry on that. But there is a worry when we need to recover the system in case of disaster, because you need to go online again. So if you use it daily with these migrations, new system deployments, you are going to be sure that the day this system that you installed a few times on that hardware using DRLM, you are going to be able to recover fast. So that's the point to use DRLM for that. So talking about the present, we are going to see a few highlights what the new version 2.3.1 now. It's has now. We replaced the API that was backed by Apache server. We have a small Golang binary that is doing the same thing. And Apache was a lot of pain for each release of new version on the edge distribution. So now it's just working what needs to work and working flawlessly. So no problems on that. We added improved the command line interface with more information. So now we are going to see if the client is online or offline, just listing the DRLM that clients that you have in the database. We had some support for the new distributions, the Debian 10, and we also show that when you we list backups, we are going to see the duration of the backup in the command, in the output, and also the backup size. It's important because if you see a very small backup or a very short time backup, maybe it's a sign that something in the configuration is wrong. So it's fast to see if something is wrong with your backup. Maybe this doesn't have an error, but the configuration it's just keeping some files, small files, and not the whole system. So it's good to have this information in the command line. So more or less, these are the outputs of what I'm saying. It's knowing showing the rear version and the client version, if the backups are scheduled or not for the client, and the green and red colors is saying that the client is online or not. If it's not online, you are going to not going to be able to do backups, etc. And in the backup side, we're going to see if this is a small backup, maybe check it if it's okay or not. If it's a small server, it could be okay, but these parameters can be adjusted in the configuration. So if you know that your backups are small, you can adjust that in the configuration, and it's not going to say you're warning. Yeah, it's okay by default, and the duration of the backups. So that's what we have today on the DRLM command line interface, and few other things that we have been improving last 6 months. And also we had a contribution from a guy that tested the project, used it for in his company, and did a pull request to run DRLM on top of a Docker container. So it's on develop branch yet. It's working, but we do not recommend for production because needs some host networking stuff, because the DRLM version needs some things that it's not container ready. So, but it's good to have a laptop. You have a consultant and you need to deploy lots of system. It's good to have a Docker image with DRLM. Just to start, do whatever you need to do and stop. So your laptop is clean and you have your installation with your golden images, etc. on your laptop to use that. So it's a good point for use, yeah? So I have a demo. We don't have time today to show the demos, but are published on a cinema about how DRLM version 2 works. Just check it. It's on the FOSDEM event also, in the link, all the links for all the demos of the today talk. But we don't have time to show you today. Maybe we can talk about it later and check it later, okay? So now let's talk about the future of the project. Well, version 3, what's going on? Well, we used the first time, we needed to be very fast to release the first version of DRLM, and we used the Relax and Recover framework for that. It's a pretty amazing framework, but for our use has some limitations. Yeah, so we thought that we need to go further, and what's coming, and what we want for the future for the project, and we're doing a complete rewrite of the project on Golang with Golang. Why Golang? Because it's multi-architecture, so we can have binaries for different systems, not just Linux, etc., etc. So it's going to be a modular design of the new version. The storage backend is going to be S3 compatible. It's a Minio. The database is going to be MariaDB from SQLite, and we don't know, but it's a modular design. It's going to have a plugin system. The agent is going to manage some plugins. The API is going to communicate over gRPC. The client is going to be in your laptop or whatever workstation you have, and you are going to connect to the core on your network. Different cores you are going to be able to manage. So it's going to be more flexible and more powerful for that. And even, we don't know, maybe it's just not going to do disaster recovery for Linux. It's going to be able to do more because you are going to be able to run the agents for Windows, macOS, AAX, HPUX, whatever we want. We can start this Golang binary on that, And if we have a plugin for that, it's it's good. So we don't know. We're just going to release the version 3 first with Relax and Recover as it is. Now it's our point and our target now. But we know that it's going to be ready for the future. And also, it's going to be able to be deployed on Kubernetes. And we have in mind that this architecture is going to work to do backups of Kubernetes systems, Kubernetes databases. So that's the point of the project also in the new version. So what we have until now? For now, we have a functional DRLM CTL command that is going to be our command line interface for the project. We are able to deploy DRLM cores on different systems from the command line interface. We're going now we're being able to deploy agents in the network, and that is going to communicate with the core, etc. And we have a base plugin system that's working, and it's doing a small backup and storing on the storage backend. Today we have that. And we also have a testing environment to test all the things that we have, and a development environment. So what is important for us is that all the communication on the development, we are developing all this on top of TLS, with all the components that are going to be communicating with encrypted communication. This is the most important thing that we thought. That if we start developing with encryption, if we have problems, we are going to solve problems the first time. Not, okay, that was working without encryption and now it's failing. What happens? No, what happens? If it's going to be released, it's going to be released with TLS. And now we drop the option, I think, in the development environment to not check the with TLS. Just, it's by default with TLS, okay? Let me explain a little bit. DR3Deep is the development, testing, and building tool of DRLM. It's a GitHub repo with a few Docker images and compose configurations that it's going to be able to deploy the complete environment, based environment of DRLM with this repo. So just cloning, building all the Docker containers and starting with your configuration of your GitHub account, previously forked repos of DRLM, core, common, plugins, etc. You're going to have a complete development environment on top of Docker. And the development box is also a container with Vim and VS Code editors in place with all the plugins needed to develop on the project. So you don't need to install Golang, libraries, packages, anything on your laptop or on your workstation. It's going to be persistent in this repo, but it's going to be clean built in your laptop. So everybody is going to contribute to the project with the same libraries, same versions, everything is the same. So if you have a problem, we have a problem. Everybody is working on the same, on top of the same platform, on the same environment. So this is good because everything is going to be the exact, every pull request is going to be tested on the same environment, et cetera, et cetera. Same versions, same libraries. So that's the point, that it's going to be easier to contribute to the new version than the version 2 of DRLM. But, well, that's the point. It's the experience that we had previously that why we offer this today for the people that is going to use, test, or develop on top of that. So we also have some demos of this development environment and the testing of the project, what it has the version 3 now, are posted here in the Evan page. We don't have time to show today, but you can check it and you can see the whole testing and how it's working DRLM now, and how to contribute with and test it with a development environment and repo. So just there for you to check. So the future of the project, we are going to keep developing the two versions, the version 2 and the version 3. The version 3 is going to have changes, but not the big changes that we are going to have on the version 3. Maybe some things that we are going to release for develop for 3 that are compatible with version 2 are going to be ported to that. And we are not doing an end of life of the version 2 until the version 3 is going to be really production ready. Okay? So, and maybe for years it's going to be useful for some situations, this version 2 of DRLM. But we are looking on the future, we are going to make and put all our efforts to develop the new version. Okay? Well, maintaining the version 2, testing and developing whatever needs for the new versions of the distribution of Linux, et cetera, et cetera. Our most effort is going to be version 3. But we maybe have some news there on the version 2 if some sponsored development comes this year. But anyway, depends on the customers that need some things that are not in roadmap. We are going to develop more things or not on the version 2. But all news and all the interesting, really interesting stuff is going to come on the new version. Okay. So hopefully you use it, you test it, or you want to contribute to the project. So it's easy to do. You can come to our GitHub repos, open issues, test it, and report whatever you have the problems. Discussing new ideas to the project. We are we always appreciate that. So we are open to new proposals. And if you use it or you are going to use it and enjoy it, please share your experience so more people is going to be able to use that. So it's time for Q&A because we have the small time for that. And if you missed something, because I passed slides very fast, if you want to check it, we have, I think, more 8 minutes, more or less, to talk about the project. Here are the slides of the event, all the information of the event today. Here the experience of a real customer in production, a big customer with DRLM. It's what they say about the project 2 years ago. No, it's not me, so you don't need to trust me. And if there is any question, I'd be glad to answer anything. Yeah?
Any plans to make it work also with Postgres or just
Maria? Well, the question was if we are going to use Postgres as a database backend for DRLM. We don't know. For now, we just have a target to use MariaDB instead of SQLite that we had on version 2 to be able to have high availability if we want off the backend, etc. And we don't know. It's just we have a connector now to a network database and could be done in Postgres maybe or whatever other database we think. But for now, we are focused on have a working version. So we are focused on those specifications. That is MariaDB, Minio for the storage backend, etc. But we don't know. It's going to be possible. So we maybe did choose you whatever you want. Maybe in this situation it's better for use Postgres, and this other situation it's better to use MariaDB. Whatever, it's possible and could be done. Yeah. The question is how the database is going to grow. Nowadays, for DRLM, we only have a very small database that it's just keeping the reference of the backups, the images, etc. So we have a very small database, and hopefully, the new one is going to be bigger, but not as big as we can expect for that. We expect that it's going to be a small database and the data is going to be compressed, encrypted on the storage backend. So we don't think that it's going to be a problem to have a huge database because we have a very small database now. So it's just for keeping the clients' reference, the backend reference, the jobs that we have scheduled, but it's really, really small database. So we don't mind on that for now. Any other question? Well, nowadays DRLM is a service for managing disaster recovery on Linux. Well, the question was, what's the link between Kubernetes? Because I mentioned Kubernetes on DRLM. Well, last year I started to use Kubernetes, the new era of containers with Docker, et cetera, et cetera. So at every conference I assisted, or at every talk, when they asked for database backup, people said, okay, put this outside of Kubernetes. Why? Because we don't have a proper solution to recover data inside that. That's the real situation now. All the backup solutions nowadays for Kubernetes, etc., whatever container orchestration, are meant for snapshotting the underlier. Why? This is good for static data. But with an open backup, open database, it's going to be a mess. You are not going to be able to recover your database consistently. So the point with DRLM version 3 and Kubernetes is going to be able to have an agent. It's going to be able to run inside these pods, Kubernetes pods, sharing the IP address, sharing the volumes. So you are going to be able to run tasks on that agent using a plugin for that database inside Kubernetes and perform a proper backup on top of that, and a proper restore if you want, without being to redeploy the whole pod, et cetera, et cetera. Just recovering and backup and recovering your data, what was always done until now with the containers. So that's more or less the link that we thought that we need to change a little bit the concept of what DRLM was, because the future is going to be containers and orchestrator, et cetera, and there is still not a proper solution for backup and disaster recovery inside that. So that's the point that we thought to see further in the future and start now rethinking the whole thing now. As I said, we started with version 1, and version 2 still has the Relax and Recover framework that was amazing for us. But we thought that in the future we are going to have some problems to implement. We've seen that it's difficult to containerize DRLM because the framework and the linking with DHCPs, etc., etc., no, it's going to be a service, and the agent system is going to be there are going to be server agents and client agents. So a server agent is going to be DHCP, TFTP, whatever, and it's going to be able to be deployed as a container also and linked using the communication inside DRLM agent system. So it's going to be easier to deploy that and extend on top of orchestrator platform and today's cloud services. So that's the point and more or less the link that why we rethink it all the DRLM stuff. So time's up. Thanks for coming, and hopefully you enjoy the next talks today in this dev room. Thank you very much.